Welcome to this edition of We Vision. Today I'm going to be talking about new technology Applied's new producer Selectra etch. It's a new etcher that's out on the market today, and it really solves some very important problems. I'll be talking about that, talk about what VLSI's take is on the technology. Meanwhile, I apologize for any kind of inconvenience that we may have caused if you had to see the video before, because we did have some technical difficulties that we improved, that we had to go back and pull it and take care of it. And now there's some new improvements to the video, new takes on what we said before. So anyway, Applied actually initially claimed that it was a radically different etch technology. So does the claim hold up? Well, it really does in a way, because it only etches with radicals. They've eliminated all the ion ablation, which is a technology that really, you know, we'd often talk about ion milling. I don't know that everybody knows what a mill is, but essentially you're ablating the surface away with ions and just pounding at it. It's a pure mechanical physical. So if you eliminate all that, it's very radically different, because every etcher since the early 1980s has had a ion etch component to it, an ion milling component to it. Ever since Applied introduced the first manufacturing worthy reactive ion etcher, the AME8100, which you can see in the first slide of the slide deck that's at the bottom of the of this page. Anyway, basically they've created a screen that screens out all the ions, so you only get a chemical reaction. So why is that important? If you look at the next slide here, essentially the building blocks, you can pull out what you want, and you can see there you're only etching the particular material, in this case as signified by a color of a block. And what's really important about that is you're only removing the molecules that the chemistry react to. Everything else is not touched, because you don't have an ion component to it. There's no physical digging into the surface or into side structures from ion ablation. So that means that you can etch in and around and only remove what you want, and only remove it where you want it, and without any kind of overetch, which has been a classic problem as we've tried to get into these deeper and deeper structures in the technology. And because it's dry, you don't get these capillary forces that cause patterns to collapse, which has become a real problem as things have gotten smaller and smaller, causing a lot of yield loss. So what kind of problems does the Selectra solve? Well, in today's world, it's become a big issue is in FinFET development, as we try to access spaces that are smaller than five silicon atoms across. In DRAM, it avoids a pattern collapse that's occurring because of high aspect ratios. In 3D NAND, it actually gives you a lot better lateral etch uniformity, helps get you past the 48-layer limit that most companies are struggling to get past because of yield issues. With gate all around, it will enable that particular technology in a way that it's been too difficult to do and too expensive to do today. And that's generally considered what will replace the FinFET. And as far as all multi-patterning less than 10 nanometer, it's going to provide substantial benefits there. So what was our take on it? Overall, you know, the last year or two, what we've heard everywhere is that etch is a key roadblock moving forward in patterning. And Selectra really breaks through that in the sense that it etches what you want and where you want to etch it. It's arguably the most innovative new etcher since the early 80s. And, you know, I could say that they'd have to prove it in the field, but they've already, when I first wrote this, they'd already had more than 150 chambers at the point that they introduced it. And by the end of the year, they should have 350 in the field. So it's already in production at multiple FinFET companies and memory makers. Customers are inserting it mid-node, which is something we haven't seen in years, that companies would believe enough in a new technology that they would insert it. Usually you wait from node to node. And the main reason is it solves a lot of today's critical problems by giving you extreme selectivity, which is just badly needed by the industry. The other thing I really liked about it was People have been talking about materials-enabled scaling. In fact, Applied likes to use that a lot. And it sounds like the materials are everything and the equipment's not important. But what they've shown with this etcher is that the materials are just the starting point, that the equipment is what really makes it happen and allows you to get the materials into structures that you need to have, which goes hand in hand with trying to advance Moore's Law to really unexpected definitions as we move forward. So anyway, I want to thank you for taking the time today. See you next time.